Joining us live now, the Deputy Opposition Leader, Sussan Ley. Sussan, good to see you. Firstly, your reaction to those fresh claims this morning?
I'm just stunned, Pete. A remorseless serial rapist who attacked 25 women and a child has kept his visa because of a direction by this minister. And yesterday we saw in Question Time, the coalition asked question after question and got the most pathetic responses from this immigration minister. He does need to be sacked. He does need to go. Every minute he stays in the job is evidence of weak leadership from Prime Minister Anthony Albanese. I'm bewildered as to why he is still there making these awful, awful mistakes.
Well, Claire O'Neill, she was on...
Sorry, she's not safe.
Yeah, she was on another network this morning saying he's doing a good job.
Well, I feel sorry for Claire O'Neill. She's not doing a good job. The immigration minister's not doing a good job. We know this because of the evidence. Now, when you look at the crimes that these individuals have committed, these non-citizens who would have been deported were it not for the minister's direction, Direction 99, you know that both these ministers have failed miserably, which is why, one, certainly Minister Giles needs to go, needs to be removed. And Pete, how can you be a prime minister who says you will keep women safe when you allow your minister to release predator after predator into the community?
Sussan, how damning that Stephanie Foster, the Department of Home Affairs Secretary, said her department had failed to meet its obligations over the crisis caused by Mr. Giles' direction.
There's some brave public servants who might try and step up and say various things in Senate estimates, and this isn't actually about the public service. I would never take issue or aim at them. My understanding is that the Department of Home Affairs actually did warn their ministers that this direction would result in 25% more visas not being cancelled, and therefore criminals, non-citizens, taking up an option to stay in the community when they should have been deported. But ultimately, Pete, this is ministerial responsibility. This is about the minister. That's what the job is. That's what the position is. That's what the executive responsibility means, that when you make mistakes as egregious as this, if you don't resign, you should be sacked.
Sussan Ley, we're out of time. We'll leave it there, though. Thank you.